A very funny thing happened on Friday. On Truth Social, Donald Trump went out there and posted a screenshot of an article that said, new, Jamie Dimon, the CEO of JP Morgan Chase, has endorsed Trump for president. And it had a little red flashing light emoji with it because obviously this is big news. I mean, I don't know about you, but I, like every other American, we've been waiting with bated breath to find out who this corrupt CEO was going to endorse, right? I mean, my God, I have lost sleep at night wondering who Jamie Dimon was going to endorse. The only problem is, 20 minutes after Donald Trump put this out on Truth Social, Jamie Dimon's spokesperson came out and said, Jamie Dimon has not endorsed anyone. He has not endorsed a candidate. So he didn't endorse Donald Trump. This thing they put out there, again, which appeared to be a screenshot, was fake. So why did Donald Trump put a fake endorsement on his Truth Social page? And let's be very clear, Jamie Dimon is not just saying right now he's not endorsing anybody. He actually came out and made that big grand announcement, you know, with a full, you know, speech basically in August that he wasn't going to endorse anybody. So we've known for a long time he wasn't going to endorse anybody, but I guess Donald Trump just decided, you know what, screw it. We're so desperate, we'll just make things up. But after it was revealed that, of course, this thing was totally fake, Donald Trump was asked by reporters like, hey, man, you posted out a fake endorsement today. Why did you do it? And Trump said, I don't know anything about it. Don't know anything about it. Like, what are you talking about? Fake endorsement? That's not me at all. The reporter kind of asked him again and said, well, you know, your Truth Social account put up this fake endorsement that, you know, Jamie Dimon has already said this is garbage. And then Trump said, well, somebody put it up. No, I don't know. So, you know, those darn staffers doing whatever they want with Donald Trump's Truth Social account without clearing it with him first, if you believe Donald Trump. Now, let me ask you, how believable does that sound, right? I mean, let's think about it logically. This was Donald Trump posting on Truth Social, which is a platform that he owns. And it's also a platform that is going down the toilet in terms of stock prices. So if Donald Trump puts something out there on a platform without knowing it because his staffers are just doing it, that could actually hurt the stock price of the company and reduce Donald Trump's paper gains. He wouldn't want that. I guarantee you there is nothing that goes up on Donald Trump's Truth Social account without him checking it first. He knows everything that goes out on that account. One, because as a presidential candidate, he has to. Two, as the owner of the company or the majority shareholder, he has to make sure nobody's going to do something to screw up his business. Either that, or he literally is the worst businessman slash candidate we've ever seen. Now, that's also a very real possibility. However, we also know that Donald Trump loves to control any and everything. So again, I don't think he's allowing staffers to just post whatever the hell they want on his Truth Social willy-nilly. But all of that underscores the bigger point. This campaign is at the point where they're so desperate, they're just making stuff up and hoping nobody fact-checks it. Hoping the people they say endorsed him don't come out and say, actually, no, we didn't, because that's all they have left. Lies and deception. And that's what we will see from now until November 5th. And depending on how November 5th goes, possibly even longer than that. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.